For more than 1,000 years, Marseille has been producing olive oil soap. Dani Alcaraz and Emily Lesbeau are third-generation soap makers at Savon de Marseille. The factory is an historic landmark, more than 100 years old, and they take me for a tour.
He's called Maître Savonnier in French. That means, the soap master. And some years ago, the soap master was
tasting
really? The soap. And with tasting, he think whether it was too much salt or not enough, if it is cooked or not cooked.
Today, the mixing is done by machines, but the soap master used to perch precariously over the steaming cauldron to stir the boiling soap for days at a time. Work so dangerous that a special shrine was built at the factory site to watch over the workers. The recipe is surprisingly simple. Olive oil, salt water, and soda ash boiled for days before being poured out to set and cut into blocks.
It must have been so hot that it would be pretty hard to handle it, right? So it would just flow?
Yes, it would flow
on the floor,
and they wait that dry it, mm-hmm. soft dry, and when it is dry, it's solid, mm-hmm. and it cuts.
Now the soap is piped in and cut into soap noodles before being molded into soft blocks of green olive oil soap. Savon de Marseille used to be used for everything from laundry to kitchen cleaning, but with the new detergents and cleaners, the green blocks of soap lost their popularity. So Savon de Marseille has two destinations, markets in Africa, where it is sold for about a dollar and still used for all-purpose cleaning, and chic boutiques across Europe and North America, selling for as much as $15 for a kilo of soap.
This is where the soap ends up. Savon de Marseille has now a niche market, selling to stylish boutiques that are demanding an all-natural soap without additives or perfume.
For Savon de Marseille, what's old is new again, making this a profitable tradition to keep. Atika Shubert, CNN, Marseille, France.